Hello everyone and welcome to this episode of Ignition Time. Welcome to our channel everyone. My name is Dr. Nitin Chhoda with Ignition Time. I work hard on this channel 7 days a week to bring you important information pertaining to the country, the economy, as well as our money. Check out my video, you'll learn more about who I am, what my journey has been like, and why you should listen to me. As you know, the conservative Democrat from West Virginia, Joe Manchin, has been a thorn in the side of President Biden and the other Democrats as they try and pass the $3.5 trillion budget reconciliation bill. Now, there is one individual who does not get as much attention as the conservative Democrat from West Virginia, Joe Manchin, and that is Senator Kyrsten Sinema. In fact, she could be an even bigger obstacle for the spending plans of the Democrats, according to this headline on your screen from the Washington Post. And this Senator Kyrsten Sinema, who's a Democrat from Arizona, is essentially casting a dark cloud over all the efforts of the Democrats. And this is a direct quote from her. "While I will support beginning this process, I do not support a bill that costs $3.5 trillion. This is what Senator Kyrsten Sinema said in a statement that basically shocked many of her fellow Democrats, because that came just hours before the Democrats were expecting to be united to advance the infrastructure bill that was painstakingly negotiated by House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. In fact, the 45-year-old Senator Kyrsten Sinema is not the only Senate Democrat to raise concerns about the size of the $3.5 trillion bill. Her objections have been largely obscured by Senator Joe Manchin, who's much more prominent, who's all over the news, and who's appeared on many, many different news stations. However, Senator Kyrsten Sinema is not someone that we can ignore or underestimate, because while Manchin may have appeared on many, many Sunday shows, Kyrsten Sinema has not done a national television interview in weeks. She's actually remained relatively silent, especially when she was asked about her recent priorities. And a spokesman for her, John LaBombard, said in a statement recently that Senator Kyrsten Sinema is, I quote, "continuing to work in good faith with her colleagues and President Biden as this legislation develops." Now, I want to be clear, President Biden has been on the phone both with the conservative Democrat from West Virginia, Joe Manchin, and Senator Kyrsten Sinema. And Senator Sinema and her staff have been closely involved in talks and have been working very closely in a very detailed manner with many lawmakers. In fact, here's a quote from Senator Chris Coons, who's a Democrat from Delaware. He said, "she's gone through the whole package and has very specific concerns and questions about specific pieces." That's what he said. And according to Coons, Senator Kyrsten Sinema wants to know more about whether the program could be quickly grown to the scale that a lot of the supporters, specifically all the Democrats, envision. Coons said, "it's a perfectly reasonable question. I spoke up in caucus and said, you know, this is one of the ones I'm really working hard on." And she said, "okay, I need answers to this, this, and this." So it's very clear that a lot of the Democrats want to get Senator Kyrsten Sinema involved. And Senator Kyrsten Sinema has also been exploring ways to means test some programs to target their effect on those who need help the most. In other words, she wants to make sure that those who need help the most are getting it. Now, I want to be clear, at this point in time, there is no news of any stimulus checks or unemployment benefits being a part of this package. So I just want to be honest with our viewers and subscribers about that. But I think that Senator Kyrsten Sinema is going to cause the Democrats a lot of problems. The fact is, Senator Kyrsten Sinema is not a fan of tax increases. And as a House member, she was one of 7 Democrats to actually support a Republican bill eliminating the federal estate tax in 2015. And she was one of only 3 Democrats who in 2018 voted to permanently extend individual tax cuts passed by Republicans the day prior. So it's very clear that Senator Kyrsten Sinema has a different point of view than a majority of her Democratic colleagues. Now, many Democrats have been super frustrated with these senators, Senator Kyrsten Sinema and Senator Joe Manchin. And many, many colleagues have said that they have become accustomed to Joe Manchin trying to be the center of attention, specifically with these major legislative issues. On the other hand, Senator Kyrsten Sinema is much harder to read, according to many of them, and her actions and her voting record makes it very difficult to predict what she's going to do. Here's a quote from Senator Richard J. Durbin, who's a Democrat from Illinois. "The conversations are ongoing to allay her concerns. We take them very seriously, respect her positions, and try our best to find common ground." So it's very clear, folks, that things are extremely difficult as far as Democrats are concerned, because they need every single vote they can get. Here's a quote from the one and only independent senator from Vermont, who is the budget committee chairman, Bernie Sanders. He said, is it appropriate for one person to destroy two pieces of legislation? I think we're going to work it out, but it would really be a terrible, terrible shame for the American people if both bills went down. And that is a real danger. And by the way, he was referring to Joe Manchin. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, in the meantime, is trying to get all of this passed. And I can tell you that she has an uphill battle at the moment. Now, some senators are actually skeptical that Senator Kyrsten Sinema will go along with the whole thing. And they feel that she wants to pass the bipartisan infrastructure bill, but not the $3.5 trillion reconciliation bill. One senator who's worked with Senator Kyrsten Sinema said, I just don't think they're related in her mind or in reality. And I think that's what's hard for people to understand. This is not all about trade-offs and hostage taking. It's just each one on its own merits. So what do you think Senator Kyrsten Sinema is likely to do? One thing is for sure, folks, she's causing a lot of headaches for Democrats. In fact, here's a quote from Senator Thom Tillis, who's a Republican from North Carolina. And by the way, they love what's happening between Senator Kyrsten Sinema and other Democrats. So Thom Tillis said this, I do believe that she just has a genuine concern with potential for overreach and negative fiscal repercussions. And he said that Senator Kyrsten Sinema shared concerns about the size of the Democrats' plan, the $3.5 trillion plan, as the bipartisan group is negotiating this infrastructure bill, but she's made no promises about where she might end up. Now, many other Republicans are actually optimistic that Senator Kyrsten Sinema will hold firm with her position. Here's a quote from Senator Mitt Romney, the Republican from Utah. Anyone who thinks she's going to be a pushover is going to be severely surprised. So as you can see, the Republicans like what's going on. The Democrats do not. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. Once again, my name is Dr. Nitin Chhoda with Ignition Time. Please click the like button. Please click subscribe. Please enable notifications. I appreciate you very much and I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next episode of Ignition Time. Once again, please click the like button. Please subscribe. Please enable notifications. Also follow us on Twitter. This right here is my Twitter feed. You'll be able to keep up with all the latest news stories on Twitter. And our Twitter handle is ignition_time. That's ignition_time. Thank you so much. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next episode of Ignition Time. Take care. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.